so that they can get aggressive even against short serves. So we've got a best of seven match here. The world number one, the world champion, Fan Zhendong, to start it off.
One.
Slow and spinny, a cautious play here after Lin Yunru leaves it right near the back of the table. Zhendong showing that he came out ready. At the World Championships 2 weeks ago, there were a few matches where Fan Zhendong looked like he was sort of feeling out the other player, just sort of testing the waters. But not here. No time for testing. Quick pace and power into the backhand side. Lin Yunru wants to shake it off, says, whew. Long push, a little side swipe on it, and ready for the quick counter.
Four.
So a perfect start from the world number one. Fan Zhendong not dropping a point yet. Handcuffing serve, Fan Zhendong putting the pressure on Lin Yunru. It's interesting, considering this is a best of seven, Fan Zhendong would have a little more time to warm up if he needs it. But knows he can't afford to let anything slip with the silent assassin on the other side. So far, nothing slipped. Tight serve, everything perfect. Serve sits up a little bit and immediately taking advantage. Fan Zhendong putting the pressure on Lin Yunru. Can be and running all around. Fan Zhendong just covering the corners. Can't ask for anything more. 8-0 in game one. Fan Zhendong bends that upper body so flexible. It's a lot of pressure on the body.
Nine, love.
Happened at the Polish Open versus Stefan Fagel in the final.
Love, 10.
Well, in terms of room for improvement, Lin Yunru is going to have plenty of that as the match continues. And he's on the board, no mercy point, though. It seems to be a thing of the past for the most part at this point. One serving 10. Tough to imagine, but it would be one of the most miraculous comebacks we've seen. And it does not happen, 11-1. Fan Zhendong will not allow, so one game to zero in this best of seven. Here in game two to change things up. Definitely shorter rallies, trying to make that first opening shot count. Fan Zhendong is just going to go for good placement on that opening when the fast serve comes in. Bottle challenge in the backhand corner is open. So the big forehand attack here. That's what the bottle challenge is all about. Nice bend on that ball. Some side spin with the top spin to make it curve.
Fan Zhendong. One, one.
Good backhand to backhand exchange here. And when the forehand of Fan Zhendong comes out, the specifics of the placement, Lin Yunru keeping it uncomfortable right in near that elbow. So quite a different start, already doubling his score from game one, the silent assassin, and leading by 1 point. And even backed off behind the table a little bit, that extra spin, the backhand of Lin Yunru. If you could have a table tennis museum that could have human body parts in it, Lin Yunru's backhand would be right there on display for people to marvel at Parallel backhand from Fan Zhendong to bring it within 1 point. Funny, in terms of backhands, in the open rally, the most explosive backhand in the game, Fan Zhendong's. The man on the screen there in the red shirt, China's number one and the world number one. Takes his chances, goes for broke down the line. That handcuffing serve in the follow-up third ball attack. Hangs on to the lead, extends it back to two. Notice how Fan Zhendong keeps his feet planted right at the baseline of the table. Doesn't step around too much. What an exchange. The open counter loop rally. Lin Wenru glides. Backhand for days, Chiquita's for weeks. Low to the net there, perfect read, catches it at the peak, and right into the middle. Challenges Fan Zhendong to decide which side of the racket to use.
Six, three.
The big point here for Fan Zhendong to stop the turnaround. Fan Zhendong fan club. That will be the majority of the stadium, although Lin Wenru quite popular throughout China. And the rest of the world, for that matter.
Let. 6-3.
What a save. It looked like he was hung out to dry, fish out of water on the forehand. A lot of rotation comes in and Fan Zhendong. That setup, Lin Wenru with a great opportunity after the fast serve comes in. Bottle challenge serve for an outright point. A big part of that is that Fan Zhendong is looking to get in over the table with the backhand banana flick.
Do not print the ball, please.
Do not breathe on the ball, please, was the warning from our umpire, Akram. Good pressure from Fan Zhendong. In terms of confidence, Lin Wenru's got his fair share of confidence. He's proven that he can beat Fan Zhendong before. But being down 0-2 after such a commanding lead early on would be quite tough. Coach Wei in the corner taking mental notes. Uncomfortable shot here as the slow spinny ball comes in. The best of seven. You save the timeout here, it seems. That was so smart. Lin Wenru saw in his periphery. Tight serve and goes for his backhand shot, but Fan Zhendong puts just enough pressure on to deter that third ball attack. Moments like this later on in the match, if it's tight, you'll see Wang Hao on his feet. Still a 1 point lead for Lin Wenru. Ooh!
Nine.
Liu, a gift. And it's blasted back as powerful as can be. Fan Zhendong. Down the line, Lin Wenru shortens it up, plays it a little shallow on the table and causes some trouble breaking the rhythm of Fan Zhendong from a step or two behind. So deuce, a big point for Lin Wenru. Nice soft touch there, not easy to do. Get the ball over the net, but keep it from going off the back of the table with so much spin on it. Alternating serves from here on out. That's long serve and the quick fire backhand.
10.
But it sails long and it's 11-10, Fang Zhendong.
I'm being told to speak, Shaki.
And it perfectly baseline. The defensive shot still not enough. So Fraser, after that game two, a drastic difference from game one, what do you think Lin Winru has to do to cross the finish line?
I think he really has to stretch Fang Zhendong out wide. Try and touch it tight and then make Fang Zhendong stretched, if he can, on the opening attack. Bring him in and out of the table. But it, I just can't help but wonder, is that service error at that crucial position in the second game going to be a moment that Lin Winru lives to regret?
I think this is part of the job. You can't make every shot all the time, and you have to take your chances on serves, so professionals know how to control their thoughts while they're playing, typically, to be the best player they can be. Beautiful shot from that angle. You had such a clear picture of how the ball just curved away and out of reach. And oh man, is that a thing of beauty.
Let 2-1.
So Lin Winru starting strong as he did in last game. But again, it's not just how you start, it's how you finish. As clean as can be, that step around. His service game is getting strong. If he can keep Fang Zhendong off the attack on the receive. Again, his deception, that variation in serve, makes it very difficult for the receiver to read. Fang Zhendong with the serves back now. Oh my goodness, just too strong. Full commitment on this one.
It's an absolutely murderous forehand there by the world champion. Got a brace for impact as soon as he turns that corner down that short side. It's the beauty of the half long. He gets a slow enough receiver. Good spin up from Lin Winru, but it's not going to be as powerful as if he served long Fang Zhendong. Good combination.
3-3.
Some extra leg work there to get on top of this ball. Lin Winru really having to turn a bit on this one. The lob will not come down.
Three, five.
For the second time this match, we saw a similar opportunity with an open side of the table there. Lin Winru making the best of this one with that wide angle backhand and then the follow up on the forehand side. Good side spin on it as well to make the lob carry back. Ambitious attempt on the receive. Ooh, re-gifting.
Four.
Wow. That's why you should always put your return address on your missed serves. You never know when someone feels like reciprocating for your generosity. Wouldn't be the first time. Fang Zhendong took an entire stadium out to lunch after a Chinese Super League match.
7-4.
Not everybody can say that. Lin Winru here, again, short rallies, putting the pressure on early. He's going to have to play out of his comfort zone. Lin Winru's very good in the rally, but the idea of a rally right now would not be favorable. 8-8. The bottle challenge in the backhand to follow up. Fong Zhendong just redirecting traffic here, guiding it back out with that backhand. Nguyen Ru with a strong opening, but had to backpedal quite a bit, and up on one foot, takes the balance out. Oh, right off the edge, too.
Five.
This is one of those rallies where someone hits the ball so hard that you think, how is it even possible? Oh, it's already on its way back, and then again. Several shots. The opening, Fong Zhendong for broke into the exact opposite corner. Precision and a little fortune for Lin Wenru.
Nine, six.
Second gift from Lin Wenru. He's a very generous player in general, but in terms of service gifts, I think he's going to try to minimize the amount of gifts given. Soft touch, perfect placement, seven, and the world number one within two.
Timeout.
And a timeout now on Lin Wenru's side. A much needed timeout. Perfect placement, seven, Lin Wenru deep to the backhand corner and earns himself three game points here in game number three. Opening Chiquita fast, and then a short stroke, just has to drop real quickly, bend the knees to get low for that one. Outstanding play, the 11, follow-up backhand to 7, the opener, and Lin Wenru able to cash in that timeout to convert his first game on the board, but no timeouts left. And deep to that backhand corner again, Fong Zhendong is going to have to look for answers, but the trick is if he gets pinned up in that backhand corner, Lin Wenru can go the other way. Lin Wenru is going to stick with what's working right now. He's just been spraying around these long serves, backhand into the body, deep right at the baseline. Fong Zhendong is used to being able to steal some attacks with more confidence and more power from inside the table, but Lin Wenru is not allowing it. Zero serving two.
One, two.
That's what a handcuffing serve is all about. Very difficult place to get a smooth stroke. And if Lin Wenru waits any longer, it's even tougher. Typically, anyway. Sometimes that buys you a little time and space to clear the corner. And the inside-out forehand is fluid as can be. Lin Wenru has been all over the news ever since his Olympic medal and even long before. But a win right here. Ma Long has already been knocked out. Liang Jingquan has already been knocked out. Both men's and women's side of the game, only the world number ones left for China of their top three. Just catching the mic there on the net clamp after an explosive forehand or two comes back into play. Big point here for Fong Zhendong. Now, in case you're curious, just tuning in, why he breathes on the racket there, just moistens it up. Fogs it up a little bit so that he can wipe the dust off and have full control and traction to grip and spin the ball. Still 1 point ahead, the silent assassin. But a heavy push, lots of backspin on this one. 3 points apiece now. And as soon as Lin Wenru slows it down a little bit, Fong Zhendong powers up down the middle. Softer one there. And even from about table height, good 6 inches below the net, Fong Zhendong authoritatively takes that. The inside out forehand as well. The crowd loving
it. 3-6.
And without a timeout left, a big string of points here. It was starting to look like, and you could feel, that Lin Wenru had a plan. And this could quickly take a turn this match. But at any given moment, anything is possible. each point worth 1 point.
Seven, three.
And not the same quality that we saw at the end of game number three. Lin Yunru with the long serve to the backhand, but Fang Zhendong brings it back a bit more into the body. Lin Yunru doesn't dare turn on that to play the forehand. A long serve of his own, and right there to clean it up, the backhand of Lin Yunru. Backhand has not come down. Fang Zhendong anticipates and handles that strong opening attack quite well. Yeah, that's the way to react. Gotta love it. Everything's fair for the fans here. Side and topspin comes in. Fang Zhendong again just keeping it different in his shots, making it unpredictable. And attempting to chop it back. It just doesn't come back over the net. It's Lin Yunru testing the feet on the other side of the table. Long serve to the forehand side. Who would have guessed after all the long serves to the backhand and body? It's a dangerous serve in general, but it works. And right back down the line, Fang Zhendong. These quick-paced rallies, Fang Zhendong just 2 points away from a 3-1 lead. But now with a backhand like this. Lin Yunru. A beautiful down-the-line opening. Remember, this is the semifinal. One of two that you will see tonight. At least on the men's side, one of four semifinals overall. It's only semifinals from here on out tonight. And the footwork is tested. The door to game number four has been closed in game number five. The final with the serves on his side.
Love one.
Good shallow spinny shot here. Keeps it nice and low off the bounce. Anything that reaches Fang Zhendong comfortably, if he has time to power up like that, it's going to be very tough for his opponent. Lin Yunru, heavy sidespin on that bounce, but well anticipated. Fang Zhendong has seen that arc before and knows where to move to set up. Quick pace of play once again, and Fang Zhendong up to the task. When you remember back to the game that Lin Yunru won, we had rallies sort of like this. Fast opening, quick counter off the bounce. It's always going to be tough to execute, but he's got to take his chances. Bottle challenge for an outright serve. It's that risky serve game with a little bit more precision against the world number one than anyone else in the world. Ooh,
two, three.
We have seen more service gifts throughout this week than in most events. Again, sometimes just a little bit of air conditioning, something to keep it cool in the room. Looked like a good serve from the start, but the net just a little bit too high on that one. 1 point lead for the Silent Assassin. What a comeback on the defense, was in the backcourt. Oh my goodness. In the blink of an eye.
3-5.
So Lin Yunru continuing to distance himself from the player in the lead.
Fight! Four, five.
It's going to be a very difficult decision for Lin Wenru to decide so quickly. Should he turn from the middle to play the forehand? That one you could see he didn't get the racket speed on it. Very well placed. Fan Zhendong tempting that middle.
Five.
So two in a row on his serve. Fan Zhendong chasing here, looking to finish this in game number five. It's funny, many professional players thought that Ma Long would be the one to win this event. But he has been eliminated in the quarterfinals. These two playing for a spot in the final.
Five, six.
So three in a row here for Fan Zhendong. Lin Wenru looking for these short rallies, big decisive shots early on. Cracking backhand does it.
Six.
Hey, Lin Wenru fan club here, looking sharp. Clever idea. Lin Wenru looking for that edge of world number one.
Seven.
Fighting and hanging on. He will fight till the very end. Remember, last time they played, it came down to game number seven. 11-8 in the seventh in favor of the world number one.
Let, seven.
The big forehand.
Eight, seven.
You can hear the difference in quality. This is something about table tennis. The sound of the contact is such a big indicator to how much spin is on it. It drives that one a bit more, meaning more forward motion and force rather than pulling and spinning the ball quite as much. A little bit off the net,
seven,
but he sets himself up
nine.
By two. Easier said than done, though. You're playing world number one here. Doesn't miss by a lot.
Eight,
has to chase
nine.
That wide forehand. And it takes a lot of work in this. You could feel the quads getting tired and crying for a break. One game point saved. Forehand does it, gets it in near the net, which gives him more freedom, less predictability, and the powered up forehand. This match will continue. Investing in his future and his career, Lin Wenru down 2-3 in games. Oh, catches the edge, but he's going for these wide angles, and he's going for broke on every shot. If he can get through this match, he'll have one night to rest, whether it's an ice bath, a massage, or two from his physio. This is what it takes out here. The pace on the backhand, but straightened up a little bit. Down the line, Fan Zhendong goes more parallel. Keeps Lin Wenru out of that backhand corner. Smart play from Fan Zhendong.
One, two.
We don't hear much out of the silent assassin, but an occasional chole in recent years. Also, an English interview yesterday that the world has been talking about online, WTT's YouTube channel. You can check that out. Lin Wenru is outstanding in English. A little bit nervous for his first time, but you'll see more and more of him in English.
Let. 1-2.
Spectacular play. It looked like it was over. The ball comes down off the top of the net. Lin Wenru, completely frantic, has to get to the ball on the chase, and from under the table near the ground, scoops it back up, gets himself into position, and hits a ripping backhand. Check this out. Opposite side of the table from the ground, and just full stroke, full force. Three serving one. The placement unpredictable as well. The only time Lin Wenru has beaten Fang Zhendong was in 2019 in Malaysia, the T2 Diamond Malaysia, 4-1. But since then, the next five times they've played have favored the world number one, Fang Zhendong. Oh, what a receive, as wide as can be. It should be no one's responsibility to have to cover a shot like that. To even reach that part of the table with the ball, let alone as fast as he did. Fang Zhendong, not afraid to take his chances either. You don't get the world number one playing afraid. Not for long.
2-5.
It is a game of risks, shot selection, and knowing when to do what. What is likely to leave you exposed? What is likely to set you up with a better chance to win the point? That's what makes the big bucks out here. Down the line, Fang Zhendong sneaks it past. On the heads of fans all around. Tough to time that. Perfectly played into the body, Fang Zhendong. Lin Wenru makes a quality, good backhand here. The two before from that camera angle didn't look quite as impressive. Again, you're closer to Fang Zhendong, though. From the side, you could see how fast the ball was really moving there. Doesn't miss by a lot, but he hangs on to this lead. As soon as he turns, the combination is broken. And the heavy spin on the push. 6-6. And a strong receive. He's fired up. Well, Fang Zhendong to a... It is too fast, too furious. Oh my goodness, what a way to finish it. The world number one, the world champion, Fang Zhendong, with the most spectacular one-shot knockout forehand.